Friends, this is a two-part summary to Mahabharata's Dharma. Enthusiasm, patience and determination. The first part. Enthusiasm for our work and duty. The Lord is not our order fulfiller. He is not akin to our concept of slot machine or Walmart and Amazon. Simply by giving some donation, charity, pouring milk and oblations, things will not happen. They will help. But we have to have the character, gumption and guts to perform our role. Krishna could have defeated the Kurus single-handedly, but he asked Arjun to do his job of a warrior. Anyway, Krishna hails from a milkman agricultural class. Not his duty in this avatar to fight. Simply it's to romance. Still, he does play this role on and off. If we have patience, pratiksha, the ability to wait out for the effects of our karma phal, and not asha, that is jalsa. One famous artist has a house named Pratiksha. Only after that he went to do jalsa. If we go with asha, expectations, there will be nirasha, despair. Take the case of Duryodhan and Arjun when they went to Krishna just before the war. Duryodhan went with the hope of getting Krishna's army, and Arjuna went with a mood of patiently listening to the Lord, pratiksha. Shakuni gave a piece of his mind on not choosing Krishna and reprimanded Duryodhan for choosing the Narayani Sena. Determination. Please do not take vows. Simply to have determination is enough. Most vows are difficult to tolerate for us humans. Make small-term promises and suffer if you break them. But lifetime vows make only once to get married and stay happily ever after. We come to a brief part two, a human aspect to all of us. Each one of us is human, just like all characters in the Mahabharata, with four key shortcomings. We will make mistakes. We have a tendency to cheat or to be cheated. We all have some illusory ideas about 100 things. Our senses are imperfect. We cannot see beyond a point, cannot smell beyond a point, cannot hear, cannot taste or feel completely. It behoves us that we will have to suffer karmic reactions. But our ego justifies our faults. Just like Karna and Duryodhan, they justified every fault in the opponent, although they both knew what the truth was. Want to retain all opulence? The quick fire formula. In any country, state, city, society, family group, if a woman is disrespected, the entire opulence of that system or family and person will be lost. Duryodhan ordered to get Draupadi to the court after the gamble, and Karna was the one who gave the orders to disrobe. Both lost. In many such cases, people have paid dearly. Shantanu, Bhishma Dev, Pandu, Prajapati, Daksha Maharaj, Indradev, Ravan, Bali, etc., etc. All very powerful and intelligent men. This is one offense we have to guard against. And the things that give speed to committing this offense of disrespect to women have been epitomized in the Mahabharata. Gambling, intoxication of various kinds like money, power, substance, not being compassionate to other living beings like animals, and in modern COVID times even to the poor husbands. Unbridled sense and sensual desires. Ultimately, it's all about balance. And that is the most difficult thing. Balance between home and office, between siblings, children, friends, material and spiritual. But the balance of life is like a simple cycle. Even if you fall in a ditch or a pit or hit a stone, you have to rebalance and continue. That is the challenge of life. Just like after the killings, Yudhishthir's remorse was immense, but he was asked to balance his emotions and continue as a king. In fact, he made the most mistakes in this whole Mahabharata. Still, the Lord did not forsake him, and neither will Krishna forsake us. And why will he not forsake us? We see in our last point. Holier than thou. We have to stop any thoughts of me better than you, my philosophy better than yours, my guru better than yours, my book better than yours, holier than thou. The biggest fights are philosophical. Maintain friendship with even those who are diagonally opposite to your thought patterns. They do not have to slot in with you. Yajnavalkya Samhita allows for diversity in thought. And who knows, they may be right in their perspective. Even Krishna never held back praise for the Kurus like Duryodhan and Karna, even though by his standards they committed abominable acts. I go by the philosophy that all saints, like you on the bookmates, definitely have a past. And every sinner like me has a future. Thank you very much.